as we come back to the leader, Mark Damar. He's now approaching then the final meters of this stage. It racks up again here. There's a little sting in the tail. This is where it ramps up towards the run for the line. Now then, what's he got left? He looks to be pretty strong to me as an attack off the front of the group here to try and catch the leader in the closing stages. I think they're going to run out of distance, and it really would be a shame if he didn't take the stage, because he's been the man of the match in the closing stages. The crowd are loving it. They're giving him maximum support. He looks back anxious. Mark Damar now fighting on for the line. He can't come quick enough. Is he going to win the stage here? Stage 5 of the Tour of Britain, right here in Hanley. 147 kilometres of really tough terrain, and he's got it. He's going to raise his arms here. He's already celebrating. Look at this. Mark Damar gives the victory salute. The rider from United Healthcare wins Stage 5 of the Tour of Britain. And here's a sprint for second. It's the Belgian Sepp van Marck riding on the Garmin Shark Team. Oh, it was close. Boy van Poppel points to the air to indicate that he was second, but it looked very much to me like the Belgian hung on to the second spot. Let's have a look at it. Sepp van Marck coming up to the line now. Yes, he finishes second, and Boy van Poppel takes third spot. Well, fortune favours the brave, and it certainly did for Mark Damar. Celebrations spilling over here, and what a day for United Healthcare. Two podium positions, first and third. You can't ask for much more than that.
And then, for the people of Stoke, there was a wait. In fact, it was 11 minutes and 45 seconds before a group of riders, including Mark Cavendish and Bradley Wiggins, finally got to the finish line in Stoke. But Damar it was then, who had time to take out his gilet, straighten his jersey and make it all look good for the sponsors. Big news, perhaps the only news in Curaçao. 16 riders finished in the same time behind him. Sepp van Marke out-sprinting Boy van Poppel in the race for bonus seconds. He gets 6, van Poppel gets 4. Lee Howard came 5th, with John Tiernan-Lock rolling in 9th place. Lee Howard then regains the lead he first won in Dumfries. The gap is just 7 seconds though to Boy van Poppel. Sepp van Marke lurks dangerously in 3rd at 17 seconds. Christian Knees guys only GC hope now at 24 seconds, the same time as Liquigas's Damiano Caruso and Enduro's John Tiernan-Lock. Luke Rowe is Sky's next best man at 6 minutes 28 seconds, 5 seconds better off than Russ Downing, who's missing a fair bit of skin from his backside after today's crash. Ivan Basso's ride did little to alter his position. Mark Cavendish drops to 35th, with his teammate Bradley Wiggins at 41st, 12 minutes and 3 seconds down. One of the biggest wins of his career then for Damar, who showed why he's not only the road race but also the time trial champion of Curaçao. He took it on with plenty to do.
Some of our guys did this race last year, so we knew what to expect, but it was a nice race. This is real bike racing. I had some bad luck the first few stages and was almost thinking about going back home, but yeah, luckily I stayed in the race and won the stage today.
But it was Lee Howard who no one had reckoned with. A strong ride in terrain which really didn't suit him hands him the IG Markets gold jersey for the second time in this race.
I just put myself in the right position and I rode quite an aggressive race, doing a few attacks myself and following some moves, and luckily I had good legs that I could stay with the front today.
Yeah, you didn't seem to have any problems. I mean, are you starting to think now you might be able to defend the jersey?
I was certainly having a few problems up the climbs, but you know, I just hung on over the top. You know, one time I was in the second group, but we managed to get back on.
Well, we might have anticipated drama on that stage, but I don't think in our wildest dreams we would have anticipated quite that much action, Matt. The question on everyone's lips will be, what was Sky playing at? What was Bradley Wiggins playing at?
A very good question. I mean, we know Bradley was one of the forward groups over the tops, over the moors, that I said back at the start would split because of the crosswinds. And he dropped back to pace Mark back on. That's my only thought. I don't think he actually knew that to the extent the gap was at that particular time.
So maybe he thought it was a minute and it turned out to be 3. Now, the fact that there are no race radios, or team radios rather, do you think that had an influence?
I think it does. I mean, definitely. Obviously, normally team managers would relay time gaps back to riders, but as it is at the moment, riders have got to make a call based on what they can see. And again, because of the nature of the terrain, it's very, very difficult to ascertain time gaps when you've got crosswinds and climbs. So again, it was an interesting thing for Brad to do, but obviously it didn't seem to be the right move. They've only got one guy in the front now.
Yeah, they ride for Christian Knees, and he's going to have to do something about young John Tiernan-Lock, because he looked good today, didn't he? Measured and fluent.
Yeah, John Tinnerlock is really, really riding well. He looked very, very easy. Even coming across the line today, he looked relaxed, composed. I think we're going to see him really light the afterburners tomorrow on those two ascents of Caerphilly Mountain.
Do we underestimate Lee Howard at our peril? Because after all, he got up Gun Hill with him today.
Well, Boy Van Poppel, Lee Howard, all the sprinters, apart from Mark, unfortunately, made it into the front group today, looking extremely strong. So, you know, I don't think Lee Howard's going to relinquish that golden jersey too easily.
No, there will be fireworks tomorrow. I'm pretty sure of that, especially after what we've seen today. Stage 6 tomorrow goes from Welshpool to Caerphilly over the border in Wales, and we have live coverage from 1:45 p.m. and the highlights at the usual time. See you tomorrow.